You know, this place feels immense in your videos. Now that I'm here, this is something that you know, a person who really had a passion for this. This is something that really a person could do, and you've laid the blueprints. Every person like you that does something like this gives countless numbers of people real experiences with these animals, makes them actually care about them, and want to make sure that they're protected in the wild.
Check it out, people. I have been graced. I've been graced by some reptile
royalty. We're the ones who were graced.
Stop it. I'm really excited because Dav Kaufman and Clint from Clint's Reptiles showed up here today. Really stoked that they're here. We're gonna hang out with them, show them around the camp a little bit. They've been here filming videos, so I wanna make sure that after this video, you guys go check out the videos they did here. Some really fun videos. Never met Clint before, and we, you know, connected. I would expect only decent people to hang out with Kaufman. Actually, let me be honest with you. I was a little nervous about this Clint client because anyone hanging out with this guy is a little
dodgy. There you go.
You know what?
Yeah.
Right. This is PG. So
yeah, exactly. Yeah. No, listen, I'm really excited they're here because, you know, it's always fun when you meet other people, other YouTubers, but more specifically other reptile people. So we're going to wander around, we're going to talk, and we're going to get into some reptile-related nonsense.
We sincerely thank all of you happy campers out there. Your support makes a real difference in our efforts here at Kamp Kenan. This week's shout out goes to longtime supporter, Ross Parnagian. Thank you for all you do and for loving reptiles.
So of course we started off here with Slinky. Dav did a really fun video with all the lizards of Kamp Kenan. Yeah. Slinky's pretty rad. You know, I love that you know, it's fun bringing these guys over here because they're reptile lovers. So it's nice to hear their constructive criticisms. It's nice to hear their thoughts about what's going on. But more than that, I love seeing them geek out like little children when they meet.
Oh my God, I have been wanting to meet Slinky for years and years, maybe 10, 15, 3 months, whatever it is.
I've only had him for seven.
Seven months. It's been 10 years that I've wanted to meet this guy then, yes. And so, you know, I've always said that it's not just famous YouTubers as famous YouTubers as, hey, don't go in that little cave there. But there's famous lizards.
Yeah.
You know, Clint's Gus Gus, and Slinky is a famous lizard, and, you know, nobody knows about my rhino iguana Ares yet, but he's a famous lizard to me. But, yeah, Slinky is very much so a famous lizard. And I've really wanted to meet this guy.
Yeah, that's so awesome. And you know, guys, you know what's fun about these kind of connections that we're making? Like, I went to Australia earlier this year. Let's get out of here.
Yeah.
I went to Australia earlier this year, and I forgot to say, watch your head.
Yeah.
People always buy the farm on that.
Whack my head,
well, you know, you're kind of, you know, you're kind of a large Sasquatchian man, dude.
Yeah, grunting.
I'm jealous of that long hair. Anyway, what's cool is I went to Australia and I had never really met Dav beyond a hello, goodbye, at like a reptile related.
Right, like a going to festival.
Exactly, something like that. And turns out that we kind of bonded on this crazy road trip with Brian Cusco, who's another great dude. So he promised he would come down and see me, and he kept his promise.
Yeah, but you know, I would be down here earlier, but something happened in the world.
I don't know. There's been a lot going on.
I don't know.
Who knows? But also, when I was out in Utah, I didn't even think to contact Clint, and it was such a mad dash. I went and saw the Mink Man, but I really have to get back out there so I can see your place and meet Gus Gus myself.
Oh, I'm looking forward to it.
Well, so check this out, guys. We are gonna show off Lagatha.
Oh boy.
So Clint, this is your first time. Have you ever been up close to
this
a-
This is my first time around a croc monitor.
Okay, cool. So what we're gonna do is, since she and I have been working together, you know, we're just gonna stay calm in there. She's great. I don't think there'll be an issue, but I'll go next to her. You guys hang back a little bit and we'll read her body language, but she's been coming so far, guys. I don't know if you've been following me on Instagram.
You go first.
But thanks. What's happened is, hey Laggy. What's happened is she's really allowing me to get closer. So that's her blind eye. Hi, sweetheart. I'm back in here with you. So you can come on over, Clint. So she's in a calm state right now. You can see she's just relaxed. She's just kind of sunbathing a little bit. And I mentioned it earlier. She really likes this dappled sunlight. And ever since I put this bamboo up, I've noticed that she now uses more of this enclosure, whereas before she was just staying up underneath the hide box. And I believe that's because the sun was just too intense.
Mm-hmm.
That this animal lives in forest and canopy, and she just wants a dappling of light. Because if you look at her, she's not fully exposed. There's some shade on her as well. So I think this species doesn't want to get super hot, which also may attribute to the fact that when wild caught individuals bask too much, they tend to get that cataract on their eye and they go blind. So it's just something that I've been messing with. It's anecdotal information. Take it as with a grain of salt, or
it
listen
makes
to
sense
it.
Though. You know?
Yeah, it's one of those things. These reptile guys. So much of what we're trying to do doesn't come from books. It comes from just spending time with the animals.
Experience, right?
So what do you think of croc monitors, Clint?
All right, tortoise.
I am a huge fan of croc monitors. Uh-huh. They're probably the most intimidating monitor that I would aspire to maybe one day have and interact with.
Gotcha.
You know, they remind me so much in their head structure of a Komodo dragon.
That's the truth.
But, yeah,
but
they do.
Far more beautiful in their patterning.
They've got that raptor head, that, you know, Velociraptor
head. The Deinonychus from Jurassic Park.
Yeah.
They nailed that. And in fact, I think those were patterned after crocodile monitors.
Really cool. Yeah, so, you know, and you know, when we talked with Kevin McCurley from Nerd, you know, there's a certain bird-like quality to the monitor lizards, also with their intelligence, and even just morphologically, like with their nictitating membrane, the way they close their eye, similar to a bird. They are, the movements very similar, but they're active. They're almost like a warm-blooded animal. And in fact, a lot of monitor lizards, guys, are studied by biologists because they are reptiles. Yes, they're cold-blooded, but there are many traits that they have. For example, like Argus monitors with the tripodding and the alertness, that they are actually very similar to mammalian characteristics. This is very interesting stuff. So you could almost look at monitors as potentially a species of reptile that is actually transitionary. That's actually maybe a part of a transition into birds. Now you'll notice there's a little millipede on her tail, and she felt that. Her tail, she reacted to this little millipede.
Wow.
And so I was noticing that as it was walking around. But guys, again, those of you following the channel, you know how much work I've put in with this lizard. Now we've got three people in here. I am just about a foot away from her. No puffing up, no issues. She's very relaxed. I'm not gonna attempt to touch her or anything like that. I wanted her to feel comfortable. Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna just move along, show these guys a little bit more, but how cool is it giving these guys, you're getting like the backstage pass, man. This is awesome.
100%.
I love it.
What a pleasure.
Yeah, no worries, man. I'm stoked. It's always fun to share what you've built with like-minded individuals. And you know, Clint, man, you had a really good point, you know, a bit of constructive criticism, and I love learning, and you can learn from anyone. You can even learn from Kaufman, you know? You can learn, I'm just kidding, that's debatable. See, you can tell we like each other, because if you're not ribbing your friends,
that's right. That's
then
right.
it's not a friendship.
That's absolutely
but Clint,
right.
You were kind of talking about, you know, I often feel when people come visit my place that, oh man, you know, I hope you like it, you know, because I've lived here, so I'm kind of almost not jaded. I love my place, but I often feel, is there enough to keep your interest?
Yeah.
But you kind of were talking about something that that maybe I should get out more or tell people more about. Do you want to share that or no?
Well, you know, so some of the thoughts I've had since I've been here is, I mean, I have been following your videos for years and years. You know, and I've been enjoying them because all of your content is amazing. And you know, the one thing that I can say is, you know, this place feels immense in your videos. And I can tell you, now that I'm here, it is exactly what I always thought it would be.
Okay.
At the same time, you know, in some ways it seems like it's so huge. You know, acres and acres and acres and acres and acres. That it's just something that's unattainable to us normal people. And
hey,
yet,
normal?
Well, probably nobody watching this, but you know, now that I'm here, like, this is something that you know, a person who really had a passion for this, that prioritized this in exactly the way that you have, this is something that really a person could do, and you've laid the blueprints, I think.
And that, you know, that's funny. I really appreciated that. Essentially, you're saying, yeah, you should get that out more. You should tell people more. And I know I've sprinkled it in, and that's something that I want people to know. Is like, hey, this, you know, not a millionaire. I'm not, you know, loaded. It's a lot of sweat equity. But this is something we can all do. And I often say, you know, there's conservation through captive breeding, through what we do, housing these animals. I want to inspire more people to do that.
Yes.
Right. And,
but to do it in a way that the animals thrive, like, you know, we're here with the Redfoots. Come on, step in, guys.
Well, and every person like you that does something like this gives countless numbers of people real experiences with these animals, makes them actually care about them, and want to make sure that they're protected in the wild in a way that they just wouldn't if they couldn't really experience what these animals are like, because it's a game changer. It's something you don't understand when you see them on TV. You don't even understand it when you go to the zoo. It's when you walk up to them and you see the way that they respond to you. It's when you put your hand on them. You know,
that's the key to learning, is being able to touch these animals, demystify them, get over a fear you may have with them.
For sure.
And now in Utah, what are you doing? You have a place where people can go.
Yeah, I mean, you know, Utah, I can't build something like this because the climate's not right. But we've created a place called Clint's Reptile Room.
Okay.
And it is essentially my dream reptile room, and you're invited.
Awesome,
so
man.
You can come and have these sorts of experiences.
Well, I don't know. Did he invite me or meant you? I think you guys are invited.
I can be
there too. Anytime I can get back to Utah, I'm going to go next year because I get to ride my bikes. I get to look for rattlesnakes, and I'm going to now go visit Clint's Reptile Room. Something else you should know that I want to shout out here. Wait a second. Did that guy get out?
Who?
He got out. He finally got out.
The big guy?
Yeah, the big guy. Let's go.
Oh, the tortoise?
While I was about to shout out. No, there's Lumpy. But look over there. That rascal. Look, there it is. He knocked this down.
He earned it.
Let's go get this Redfoot in. Yeah. You guys, they've been following the channel. You guys know that I have this one Redfoot who can climb out of the Redfoot enclosure. And I've actually put a time lapse to see where he was getting out. So I wound up putting a few more boulders there. But he's such a lunatic that he gets out. Look, the grass truly is greener on the other side.
I'm not even avoiding the puddles anymore.
Just go right through it. Like, look at this guy go. You are a rascal. Now he knows he's been caught. Watch. He knows he's been caught.
I've seen him book
like, oh no, don't take me away.
Look guilty like that.
Oh, isn't it? Look, caught red beaked right there. That's so funny. So I'm going to go grab him. Here, do you want to hold him?
Well, I was going to grab the camera and film me carrying him.
Go ahead. Yeah,
they
no
never
worries.
Get this angle.
Oh, wow. Look at that. Yeah, so this guy is a character, but you could see that rock must have scraped on him, so I'm gonna have
God,
to figure out.
These guys are
out.
Tanks.
I know. Look at this. I'm gonna have to figure something out. But anyway, that's excitement here at the camp. You see, that's as exciting as tortoises get. But I was actually gonna talk about Dave. What's really cool about these two guys hanging out today is they're not all talk and no action. Come on, man.
Right.
I don't know. Some of you will get what I just did. Some of you will not. But it doesn't matter. But anyhow. This guy actually wrote his second novel. And I want to show, before we leave, I'm going to show the book. What's going on?
I gave you an advanced reader's copy.
Oh, okay. Was I not supposed to say something?
No, you can say something, but you know, it's
the
not
deepest,
be
darkest
available yet.
Sir.
But I'm going to make a post on my community tab on my channel when it's available. But it's coming out. And so I gave Clint and Kenan, almost the first two copies.
Get out of
here. Three, five, 10 copies. But anyway, I wanted you guys to have the advanced reader's copy of this. But thanks for the
very
pitch
good.
On that.
Yeah, no
but,
worries. Yeah. I'll show you guys before we say goodbye. I'm going to actually wander around. They actually have toured the place. I just wanted to get them on camera and document this momentous occasion of these two reptile luminaries showing up to Camp Kenan. It gets a little lonely out here.
You know what I love about your place is that everything is climbable.
Yes.
You know?
Yeah. Apparently, because the tortoises can climb them also.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Curly-tailed lizards. I don't
know why Dave and Clint can just kind of roam and.
I could be here.
We could
all
go
day.
Swimming over here.
Yeah,
with
it's
the,
fun.
With the cichlids.
So tempting with the heat.
Yeah. Oh, I know.
If we didn't need lunch so bad.
Yes.
We'd be in the pool right now.
Yeah. I'm
so this is what I'm going to do, folks. We're going to actually wind this video down. I just wanted you to meet two people that I hold in high esteem. I'm glad to say I have a new friend in Clint. It's always nice, instant connection like that. I want you guys to check out their channels. We'll have links in the description below. Follow along. Dave does a lot of cool videos where he goes into the wild and actually finds species in the wild. In fact, he actually did a video where you saw wild water monitors.
Absolutely, in Thailand.
That's incredible, man. How many of you would love to see wild water monitors just running around Thailand? I know I want to go.
Retics, and I figure if we keep them, people just don't make the connection between how to, you know, what a care sheet is all about and what they're doing in the wild. And we can learn so much more from figuring out what they're doing in the wild, what the humidity is that they live in, what the temperature is, what, you know, retics are up in the trees, they're not on the ground, that sort of thing. And that's just what I tour
invaluable,
the world.
Invaluable resource. So go check out his channel. If you really love reptiles, you'll learn a great deal. And we are planning on doing some trips together, so
for
it's
sure.
going to be fun.
For sure.
I'll get back out to Utah to hang with you, Quinn.
I'm looking forward to it.
I'm really stoked you guys showed up. All right, guys, before I leave, I'm going to show you the old Kamp Kenan machine here, but check it out. Look at it. It's an actual book, people. Elysium Coast. Sea turtles in Costa Rica. It's a novel based on a true story from Dav Kaufman.
Yeah.
This guy right here.
Look on the back, see? It's proof.
Whoa, check it out. Who is that handsome man?
Look at the state.
So unique. This guy's so unique.
So unique.
It's a little pretentious.
When I was a kid, we were very poor. I couldn't afford vowels. Therefore, my name is spelled the way it is.
Ah, there you go. All right, guys, I hope you like enjoying us knuckleheads yapping a little bit. Check them out. We're gonna go get some Mexican food. See you guys soon.
Rattle on.